Just goes to show you, sometimes a classic never dies. This is a 1989 Itasca Sunflyer. Little Class A here at Haylett RV. Just came in on trade. You know, being an 89, the first question you're going to ask is, okay, tell me what's wrong with it. And the answer, surprisingly, is nothing, really. I mean, it's an 89. It's gone through history. It's technically an antique, after all. But mechanically, it seems we're good. The tires are in good shape. It looks like anything it's ever needed, it has received. It looks like it's got a fiberglass roof, and it looks like there was at some point a little puncture in it, and I can see a spot inside that led to a brief period of water penetration. But I got up there and I even took a picture of it. If you're just on YouTube, I leave you a link in our video description. It will show you all of the used motorhomes that we have in stock. And I took a picture of the roof of this one that you can see there. And that will show you, that where they did some resealing. And it doesn't look recent. So it had a leak in the past. It was small. It was addressed quickly. It's been resealed. It hasn't had been a problem since. So it's unfortunate it was there. But what it shows you is that these weren't people that just, only took from their motorhome. They give back when they needed to. The biggest reason this was here is not because they were unhappy with it, but they started going to the RV shows, I think. They started seeing slide outs, and they started seeing how big these things were. And back in 89, stuff just didn't have that mechanical ability. They just weren't building that yet. And, they said, man, for the money that we're looking to spend, look at how much fifth wheel we can get versus the tiny motorhome we could get. And they said, you know what, we're going to swap this out for a nice Jayco fifth wheel. And there you go. You know, we had the right one here. We put the right deal together. And now we've got this pretty cute overall, not too bad little motorhome. The only trick with all of these windows is it makes it a little hard to do my camera work because I kind of can't point right at the windows. I always got to kind of angle down like this a little bit. So if the camera gets a little dark on me as I go, I'm sorry. Again, if you want to see some more photos of it, there's a link in the video description. You know, check for price and availability. That'll take you to the Haylett RV website where you can see full photo tours. We've got asking prices and any specs I've been able to dig up on here. Now, understand, guys, this is a 1989. I just don't have specs available on this thing. Like, I don't know the holding tank capacities. I am sorry for that. If that's what you're looking for, then I apologize. I'd rather tell you up front, I can't help you with that. But, if you want to know about condition and function of stuff, by and large, she looks okay. I mean, it really doesn't look too bad. It does have the hitch with the seven-way plug on the back, so if you want to put a little chase vehicle behind you, you can do that. And I tell you got lots of glass in this thing. If what you're looking for is scenic views, either at your destination or down the road, this coach is definitely on the right track for you. You have about a 270-degree viewing with this thing. Standing up here on the doghouse, which is what we call kind of the engine compartment in the business here, we call it the doghouse. Looks like, pretty standard layout for any no-slide Class C. Over here, this is that little spot where I said there was a little puncture in the roof membrane that has since been repaired. So you can see that, yes, there had been some water in here, but you can also, you can feel that it's still solid underneath. So this is, it never got far. This is very cosmetic only in nature. It's very superficial. It's there. And keep in mind, I went out of my way to tell you about this. I could have never told you about it, and you could have found it when you showed up, but that's not the kind of business we run here. I'd rather you guys know what things are. We try to be fair and clear and transparent at Haylett RV, Let's not mince words. There's a cheaper way you could spend a weekend, but this is a lot of fun. So we want to make sure that you're calm and cool and confident working with us. We don't want to bait and switch into nothing. Traditional walkthrough middle bathroom. We do have nice extra hanging storage or pantry, whatever you need it to be right here. That never hurts. So, pretty, like I said, normal walkthrough middle bathroom. This has a very low-riding, low-rise chassis, which actually kind of, you saw sort of a rebirth of some of these things in a few Thor models where they were making actually a Mercedes chassis. The whole idea is that it rode lower. It wasn't, it's the super big duper wide body of some of these things. That looks like about a brand new mattress on there too. Holy cow. I'm wondering if that's not the mattress out of the fifth wheel that they bought. It doesn't look like it because it's not in the wrapper, but it's hard to say. Anyway, big cross breeze windows back here. That giant headboard window in the back giving us all kinds of light. You can see it's actually flooding out the camera. This is prepped. If you want to add a second air up here, you can do that. And in our Haylett RV service department, we have the ability to do all that stuff for you. A coach like this, of this age, I highly recommend you visit us here in Coldwater, Michigan at Haylett's and put your hands on it in person. Take it for a test drive. That's fine. I wouldn't expect you to buy a motorhome without doing it. That's perfectly fine. But you're going to have questions. And the older a coach gets, in my experience, the more specific those questions get. And there's just no way I can cover every ounce of that in a quick little introductory video like this. Hopefully this gives you an idea of what the coach has to offer for you. I definitely think it's more than a fixer-upper. I mean, it's more than that for sure. You could, turn the key, throw some mac and cheese in the cabinets and head on down the road. There's nothing really wrong with it that I can detect. So, don't hesitate to call with a couple questions. If it looks like it's the right one, give us a call. Schedule a time you can come in and see it. I definitely recommend calling before just blindly showing up, because older RVs like this, because of its age, it has a lower price tag. People just come out of the woodwork, and I mean from all over in the country. This will go quicker than it goes slower. So definitely call ahead before driving 4 hours to hopefully come see it, because we are crazy busy right now, and I don't want you folks to, burn your gas money for no reason. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.